moved up into the junior high. So unfortunately, many of those presentations ended in either tears or a heavy feeling of dissatisfaction. You can choose which is worse. But my voice and my hands always betrayed the shaky feeling that I got whenever I presented, and I felt as though nothing would ever change. Now, that was just me being a bit overdramatic at the time, but I did steadily improve on my own. The only problem was that it wasn't at a pace that I wanted. So I had this dream that I would progress by leaps and bounds suddenly, but the only problem with that goal was that I wasn't going to push myself out of my comfort zone to achieve that goal. So I wasn't going to, say, take a course in public speaking, or I wasn't going to seek out opportunities to present in public. So I was stuck in this kind of limbo area where I had this big goal, but I wasn't going to go on a journey to achieve that goal. So, then my 8th grade social studies teacher convinced me to join Youth in Government, also known as YAG, as an intern. Now, as an intern, every year I had to read a 60 to 80 page case, write a brief and oral argument on that case, and then present my oral argument at a statewide convention at the Capitol, or at the Pennsylvania Capitol. So needless to say, I was a bit apprehensive at first because presenting my oral argument meant presenting it three times in front of various justices, and I was just convinced that I would burn and crash in front of all the justices in all the courtrooms that I went into. Nonetheless, I pushed through and I went to the statewide convention, and at my first model convention, I actually received a lot of positive feedback from the justices, which was a bit unexpected. The main critique was obviously that I needed to speak up and be more confident in what I had to say. The only problem with that was that I was not at the point where I was comfortable enough with presenting that I could speak up. So I just had to grow more confident. And their feedback really helped me in that path to gain more confidence. And during the 4 years that I was in Youth in Government, I steadily progressed and I did improve by leaps and bounds, which is the goal that I wanted. So I remember the first time that I didn't hear the words speak up or be more confident from the justices. And let me tell you, that was a big milestone for me. I was so used to hearing the words, you're so soft-spoken, please lean in closer to the mic, we can barely hear you. So it was really rewarding to hear those words from people I looked up to and people who I really wanted to kind of model in my own Youth in Government career, I guess you could say. So yeah, it felt as though my hard work had finally paid off. So that was always a good feeling. So Youth in Government taught me so much about presenting and how to be more comfortable with presenting. So I'll briefly discuss two practical and two more abstract ideas that I learned through YAG. So first, contrary to popular belief, I did not learn that practice makes perfect, as the old saying goes. There were plenty of times where I practiced and practiced and practiced my material and something still went wrong. So I just had to admit that something went wrong and move on with my life. So instead, I learned that practice allowed me to become more comfortable with what I was saying and how I was delivering my message. With practice, I could deliver a more natural and more meaningful presentation. In addition, I learned that the trick to presenting is not making the nerves magically disappear. I can attest to the fact that that probably will not happen for me, at least. My hands are still shaking, just like it was the first time I was presenting. Instead, I found that the trick for me, at least, was to transform my nervous energy into something of which I could be proud. I realized that accepting my nerves as they are and redirecting my focus onto the actual deliverance of my message really redefined the way I presented. I could speak louder and more effectively, and I could finally speak and be proud of myself. Now, I really hope that this presentation will be of some use to anyone listening. Presenting is difficult. I for sure can attest to that, but it should not serve as a barrier between you and your goals. So go. go and speak and be proud of yourself for doing that. Thank you.